On the Threshold of Time is an annual exhibition held at Art Heritage, showcasing the works of young and emerging artists. Now, in its 8th edition, the exhibition has taken on a new incarnation by being online as well as in the gallery. In this edition, titled Unseen, 5 artists take on topics related to identity and gender. We start with the paintings of Amit Saha, whose work focuses on the transgender community. He talks about the inspiration behind his work.
जब मैं कॉलेज में था मेरे बहुत सारे ऐसे क्वेर कम्युनिटी में बिलोंग करते हैं मेरा दोस्त था ऐसे हम मिलते थे उनका जो सोसाइटी में जो एग्जिस्टेंस है वो जैसे बाहर आते हैं वो जो जैसे सरवाइव करते हैं वो मुझे बहुत अट्रैक्ट करता था तो मैं सोचा क्यों ना ये भी मेरा पेंटिंग का सब्जेक्ट या टॉपिक हो सकता है तो मैं ये सब्जेक्ट चूज किया था मैं इन लोगों से साथ बहुत बात किया जब मैं काम शुरू कर रहा था या काम करके उनको दिखाया था वो लोग बहुत इम्प्रेस हुए तो उन लोग और भी मुझे हेल्प किया कि ये जगह ठीक करो ये जगह सोच सकते हो तुम इसके और डेप्थ में जाओ शुरू से मेरा जो पेंटिंग था वो पहले बहुत एक्सटर्नल टोपोग्राफी था मतलब बाहर से फिर बाद में जब उन लोगों से मैं और भी डिस्कस किया काम को लेके तो वो लोग बोले नॉट ओनली दैट कि तुम सब इसमें ही काम करो कि ये लोग क्यों ऐसे आते क्यों ऐसे दिखाते हैं क्यों ऐसे मेकअप करते तो ये भी तुम्हें दिखाना चाहिए और भी इमोशन एग्जिस्टेंस फीलिंग सब कुछ मैं डालने की कोशिश किया
Moving on, Pallavi Singh addresses metrosexuality and its history and mythological roots.
We have been somehow conditioned to, you know, believe that beauty and grooming are inherently feminine. This kind of stereotyping is always makes me curious. And I want to understand that, you know, how society is trying to perceive them. In my work, I find like I'm a director and I'm directing the characters. Every image is like a scene for me and the narration is building on those scenes. Each pieces are like, you know, it's kind of a, like a drama which is happening. So before making that, I thought I want to introduce the characters. And these characters are, it's not like any single representation. These are like basically amalgamation of people around me or the stories which I've heard or which I'm experiencing. So these characters have been come from there. So then I thought like I'm creating this character and I will name them. So I will name them like the corporate raider, the real man or the mirror man or ad man and somehow show their relationship to each other. The man not only introspecting his own insecurities about metrosexual need, but even how the commercial world is playing to that. It was basically because when I was doing Bazaar I have heard a lot about this magazine, Harper Bazaar. Harper Bazaar is quite famous and it's all about fashion and giving you every time that what is, you know, every season some new things are coming, keeping you an update over it. And the moment you get used to it, there's another update. The other work, which is Mardo Wali Baat, but again that idea that what this phrase means, what is this, what is the origin of this phrase, and how I am perceiving. These are some questions which have made me to work on this idea right now. If I like loosely translate this statement, it can mean various things. It's like what makes you man, or think which these are the things which will make you man. So these are again a question on gender stereotyping. Another work which I did called the Corona Times, which I say it's a very situational work. Though again the grooming is an important role in this work, but somehow it gives you a more inner depth to it. It's like how that simple act has become because of the lockdown that we were facing during that time. How this simple act of beautification or the grooming has also become, you know, painful and monotonous for us. And it was like waiting for a Godot for me. This whole situation again was like a drama for me.
Mm-hmm. Rather than addressing societal issues, Natasha Sachdeva and Tarun Sharma, the next two artists in this show, deal with more personal matters. Natasha's work is about body image-related issues, something she has personal experience with.
People are always trying to show how happy they are. They never show their vulnerable sides. And through my works, I want to celebrate the body that has a lot of baggage on it. I have been someone who has always dealt with this body issue because I am a PCOD patient, wherein there's a hormonal imbalance in a female body, and because of that there are multiple changes in a body, weight gain being the main thing. Earlier also I used to get a lot of comments, suggestions that you should do this to, you know, lose weight, and now when I have lost weight I get a lot of comments that थोड़ा खा लिया कर. सो दिस इज़ वॉट आई हैव बीन यू नो थ्रू. लाइक आई हैव सीन बोथ द साइड्स. आई यूजली लाइक टू पेंट फीमेल बॉडीज बिकॉज आई माई सेल्फ कैन रिलेट टू इट. माई मीडियम विच इज़ वाटर कलर एंड पेपर. सो आई थिंक यू नो दे बोथ आर वेरी फ्रेजाइल, वेरी सेंसिटिव मीडियम्स. लाइक देर इज़ नो यू नो स्टिफनेस इन दीज मीडियम. आई थिंक दे डू अ लॉट ऑफ जस्टिस टू माई सब्जेक्ट. Because like my way of treating watercolor is a layer to layer process, like where, and I do it in a very, you know, diluted way. Like there's a lot of water and a very less color. So, and watercolor being, it's a very, you know, intricate medium where you have to be very careful, but also it gives you a lot of freedom. So when I create my layers of skin, so I don't know like how the next layer, when I do the next layer, how the result will come. Like if I'm making a spot of the body, like a mark on the body, so you know I have no idea how will it look. Like I do imagine it, but like whatever the result is, it's very, you know, uncertain. And that is the beauty, I think, of this medium and my work. I think they all go very well together. When I think about my work, I feel there is so much inside the body. Like, you know, if you see very carefully, it is not just pure skin or flesh. You know, there are lines, there are marks, there are, you know, wrinkles. So I really, you know, want to explore or celebrate that side.
Tarun Sharma's work is also personal in nature, coming out of a period of a severe illness that he faced.
It was a very helplessness kind of phase for me. Even when I was recovered, I was not connecting with the work that I was doing previously. After I was able to move, I started observing people who are almost in a same condition, who are almost like living on the streets, helplessly, begging. Some people don't have eyes. Some are not able to move. Like everyone has their own taste of helplessness. Inside house also, I was seeing my mom differently. I was seeing my grandma differently. Like I was just observing how everyone is helpless at every stage of life. Like I tried to focus on the skin of the people. Like I've not made some fancy clothes, or I've just tried to like the human connection between you and me is my skin, not my clothes. Like clothes are materialistic, clothes shows our status, but skin is the part where you and me connect. Through this project, like through these works and after my illness, I think I've quite, like there's a wide arc of transformation that has gone through.
Finally, we come to the work of Bhuval Prasad, whose paintings are inspired by his time in Banaras. His work is observational and a little removed compared to that of Tarun and Natasha's.
कोई भी चीज़ अगर देखता हूँ, अपने आसपास का जो इन्वायरमेंट है मैं उसको देखता हूँ, तो जो मैं ड्राइंग बनाता हूँ, जो पेंटिंग बनाता हूँ, वो उसी से रिलेटेड होता है. जैसे कि कोई विलेज एरिया में लोग बैठे हुए हैं, ग्रुप में बैठे हुए हैं, तो वो उस ग्रुप को मैंने फॉलो किया, मतलब कि स्केच किया, ड्राइंग किया, फिर उसके बाद वो चीज़ें फिर कंपोजिशन में भी मेरे आती हैं. तो कुछ कुछ जो है कि जो आप बैकग्राउंड में ड्राइंग्स वगैरह देख रहे होंगे, सर उसमें मैं फोक आर्ट जो है उससे रिलेटेड मैंने कुछ कुछ काम किया है। जो मेरा काम डार्क और गाढ़ा दिख रहा है आपको, तो इसमें क्या है कि मैं बनारस से कॉलेज ऑफ ये बनारस से मैंने VFA किया, तो वहाँ पे जो उनका बनारस का एक इन्वायरमेंट है वो बहुत ही डार्क टाइप का है। जैसे कि आप शाम के टाइम पे नदी के किनारे आप जाएंगे गंगा जी की, तो बहुत सुकून मिलता और बहुत डार्क स्पेस दिखता, पूरा दूर दूर तक आपको डार्क स्पेस ही दिखेगा। मैं काफ़ी बोल्ड काम करता हूँ, जैसे कि फिगर्स वगैरह बहुत बोल्ड होते हैं और बैकग्राउंड में छोटे छोटे कुछ कुछ काम कर लिया मैंने, और ब्लैंक स्पेस मुझे बहुत ज़्यादा लगता है कि ब्लैंक स्पेस अगर है तो उसको छोटा छोटा ड्राइंग करके कवर किया जाए और एक एक स्टोरी उसमें दिखे।
On the Threshold of Time is currently on display at Art Heritage in Triveni Kala Sangam in New Delhi and on our Artsy page. If you'd like to come see the show, send us a mail at ahg@artheritagegallery.com or call 8800448713. We look forward to seeing you at the show.